Hey everyone out there, I hope you're good. I want to do a video here where I share my heart with everything that happened with our tent that went down, with the persecution we have seen, and how people end up at the hospital. And some people almost died or could have died in what happened. Many people heard the story, and I'm going to show you some footage here in this video also. And I'm going to show you some new footage you haven't seen before of what actually happened. And I'm going to share my heart in this. First, many people have prayed for us. I'm so thankful for your prayers. It was crazy. It's like nothing we have ever seen before. Many people also comment. And some people say, Tom, why didn't you stand up and spoke against the storm? We spoke, we stood up, we spoke, and the storm came. Some people say, but that was an attack from the enemy, and where was God? And it was an attack from the enemy, but God was there. And we saw God's hand in the midst of all of this. And I want to share my heart with this, because there's so many ideas and many people, some people have said, hey, that is from God who tried to stop you. You had to stop doing what you're doing. And more people are saying, don't stop doing what you're doing. And there's so many different voices speaking right now. So I just want to share my heart in it and what we see God is doing. First, I want to share something. I believe in the book of Acts and the early church, how they were living, that should be the normal Christian life. I've been sharing that again and again and again and again. I believe in that life where we see miracles, where we see healing, where we see deliverance. I believe that people need to repent, turn away from their sins, get baptized, and they will receive the Holy Spirit. I believe in that. I've been preaching that for years, and we are living that life. I believe that Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever, and the Holy Spirit is therefore the same yesterday, today, and forever. I believe that what we read in the book of Acts with the early church should be the normal Christian life for us today. And I'm seeing it. I'm a testimony. I'm walking testimony that Jesus is the same. We are seeing miracles. We have been led by the Holy Spirit. We have seen things that look like the book of Acts. And some of you already heard some of my testimonies. Now I can share one more testimony. We went down with a tent. Because this is also part of the book of Acts. This is also part of the early church. If you look at Paul, he was a guy who saw miracles. Paul was building the church. Paul, he lived an amazing life. He lived a full life. We love the stories of how they took the handkerchief from Paul and lay on the sick and they got healed, and the miracles God did, and how Paul started many churches. But there is another side of that. And Paul, he said here about himself in 2 Corinthians 11. He said about himself that five times he had received lashes from the Jews. 3 times he had been beaten with rope. 1 time he had been stoned. 3 times he was shipwrecked. 1 night and 1 day he had spent in the deep. And then he talked about how he was on journey or in danger there and danger there and danger there and danger there and danger there. And he continued talking about all the time he had been in danger, how he had many sleepless nights, how he had hunger, thirst, without food, cold, and how the thing that really pressure him is the concern for the church. This is Paul's life. I have not yet been stoned. I have not yet experienced beaten with stones or rope. I've not yet been gone down with a ship, but I've fled my country and I've now gone down with a tent. It was like going down with a ship. There was chaos. When the tent came and took us all away, it was chaos. People was running all over. You can see some pictures here. And you can see people was running all over. They were laying down. Some people had fainted. Some people was walking around and blood was running out from their face. People was hurt. This was real. This was real. We went down, not with a ship, but we went down with a tent. And it was a big, big attack. It was like, it was crazy, like we had never seen before. Some people said, yeah, Tom, how can you say it was demonic? Let's say like that. The wind came suddenly. It came as a big, big attack. We have sent everyone away. We have cleared out the tent. There's no chairs in the tent. And then the wind came. Some people have said that, hey, you should have put the tent up better. The tent was really good. The fire chief, he said in a TV program later that they have expected the tent and the tent was in order. I have a video here where you can see the power of the wind because the tent was solid. But the poles broke. And you can see a video here where you can see how the poles broke. I want to show the video again so you keep your eyes on the white pole there. And here you can see the white pole, how it just broke in two. And the tent went down. People was, when the tent went down, everything just was torn out. The big thing that was keeping it down to the ground, it just, everything was torn out. And we saw things laying many, 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 many feet from the place. It was just all over. This was like a demonic wind. That was like an attack. There was a guy standing on the top of the hill, looking down in the valley where we stood. And he saw the wind come. But he did not feel the wind up where he were. It was like the wind was down in the valley where we were and not in the top of the mountain, of the hill. That is not normal. The fire chief had said he had never seen a wind like that before. The way it happened, it was just so special. After the wind had come and after everything had calmed down, one of our guys went to the top of the hill and he took a picture. And I want you to see this picture. Look at this picture. Now it was calm after the storm and you see how the light from heaven was shining down exactly there where we were. And I want to say it was an attack. It was a great, great attack against us. We have got our prophetic word before we left on the revival meetings that our enemy would try to discourage us and stop us before we really get started. And we went to Chicago. Some of you have heard the story. Somebody got a dream and everything happened according to the dream. How the police came and said we are not allowed to be there. How the police left. And then how the police came back later with two fines and two papers to two people. And it happened exactly as the dream. And you can see another video about that I put in the link of this description. So in Chicago, somebody got a dream, prophetic dream, what will happen. And it happened according to the dream. From the police came, from two police came and gave us the paper and how they tried to shut us down. But we saw the kingdom of God. We saw amazing things. Then we went to New Hampshire and we experienced attack like we had never experienced before also. First, it was from the locals, fear and things come and the COVID-19 and a lot of things happened. But that attack somehow changed during the week and we got a good news report also where people started to share the good story and it was not only the lies. And we had an amazing time in New Hampshire. We saw the healing, the power of God. But we also felt we were on attack. Somebody have got a new word that there would be a quiet and then a big attack would come on us. And it was quiet. And then that day, the big attack came. And we see it as an attack, the way it happened. And it was not only the attack, was not only just to show you what is happening. There was three couples who was helping us, local, setting up the tent. Eller being local, part of the invitation for us coming there. Three couples. Two of them was in the tent and got attacked. There was only one who was not in the tent. Then you should think that he did not get attacked, but he did in his home. The day before, suddenly his wife felt like something started to grow on the neck. Some fluid started to grow and in the end, she couldn't breathe and she almost fainted. And he was ready to take her to the hospital and his wife was fainting and she couldn't breathe and something was growing and he was praying and trying to take her up and she fainted and then suddenly they burst on the neck, and fluid was running out, and then she could breathe again. He had never experienced anything like that before. So he was not in a tent, but at home he experienced an attack. Why? Because the attack was on the whole team, not only those in the tent, those who was there helping with us, working with us, sitting it up. And I felt it was an attack on us on the last Reformation. One of the poles flew through the air and flew into the truck and went through the truck, make a hole through the truck. And you can see a picture here where I'm pointing of that. And look, it's just in the TLR logo. There in the TLR logo, the pole went through. The error hit us and we got slain and we got hit and we went down with the tent, like Paul went down with the ship. But as an angel appeared to Paul in the night and said, the ship is going down, but the people are going to survive. Don't be afraid. Stand up and be encouraged. The same way our tent went down, it got torn different places. Our pole got destroyed. Different equipment got destroyed. But we got hit, but we did not go down. Six people from our team was at the hospital, but we all survived and we are there and we are stronger now than ever before. Many, many people share testimony how when the wind came, it was like there was forced to the ground and like something kept them down and they felt how the poles was flying past their head. One woman got hit just there from a pole who went past her, beside her. If that have hit there or there or there or there or there, she have not been there today. Other people felt they were slown down or took their head down and felt how the poles and all things just went over them. It was chaos in the moment. It was chaos. When everything happened, I tried to run around and see if everything was okay. And people was laying down and different places. And I was trying to get an overview of what was happening, but some people was missing. Some of the people was missing was my own family. I couldn't find them. And then I looked at the tent and I saw things was laying under the tent. So one time I thought that my wife was laying dead and my family was laying under the tent. It was not fun. It was crazy. We were running to the tent and we were trying to lift up that tent and I was sure I would see my wife laying down there dead. And it was just terrible, to be honest. We couldn't lift it up. We couldn't lift the tent. It was too heavy and it was all over the place. And we were laying on the tent and trying to come in. And then we saw there was something laying and I couldn't come down. And I called a guy with a knife, come with a knife, cut it off. And he tried to cut up the tent so we could get our hand down to see who was laying under the tent. It was real. It was like a war zone. But we came down. There was no one under the tent. It was just equipment and other things that was laying. And after going through the whole tent, we find out, okay, thank God there was no one laying under the tent. Later, I found my family who have already went out and they have gone in the bus just after it happened. We went back to the campground, to the place, and we did a counting who was there and who was missing and get an overview. And you can see pictures here. People were sitting in the corner. The police came, the ambulance came, everyone came. It was chaos. It was real. I've never experienced anything like this before. I never experienced death come so close. People was crying. People was praying. People was shouting to God. And it was real. It was like going down with a ship. We just went down with the tent. But we saw God's hand in it. And that is the testimony. In the midst of that, we saw God's hand. There were so many things that could have gone wrong. There were so many more things where people could have died. We sent the people away. Most of the people just hour before it happened. Or half hour before. I said everyone had to leave now. We have removed all the chairs. If the chairs had been there, there have been so many more who have got hurt. The way it happened, we have got many people already out of the tent. ready to go into, ready to go into the boss. So we are in the right side of the tent. And the way the Holy Spirit God just came and kept people's head down so they did not get hurt. We got slain, but we survived. I will never forget this day. I'll never forget this moment. And to think you have lost your family and you think you have lost your people and that they have died. It was a scary moment. I spent a lot of time praying about and thinking about it. It was scary. It was scary, to be honest. We have been crying a lot. And there's a lot of emotions also when I talk about it here. But I was like, God, you did not bring us to America for us to die here. You brought us to America to see a breakthrough. And we got a word, and the word was our enemy would try to stop us before we really get started. And we have been under attack the last month, first in Chicago with the dream and news, and then here with the tent that went down. But we are not stopping. We are not stopping. We went down with a tent, but we are not stopping. And our people, our team, have just come so much closer together. I never experienced a team coming so close together as here. Why? Because we survived this together. We went through the crying together. We went through the blood together. We went through the broken bones together. We went through the attack together, and we saw God's hand together. How God, He was faithful in the midst of that. And how God, He was there. So I want to encourage you out there. This is a real life. We are not promised an easy life. We are promised a real life. Paul, after one of the ships that went down in the end of Book of Acts 28, we read how Paul, he came to Malta, the island. And what do we read there? We read how a snake came out and bit him. And everyone thought that now he was going to die, but he just shook off the snake in the fire and nothing happened. Paul went down with a ship. We went down with a tent. Paul got attacked. We got attacked. But we are strong and we are going to break through, and I'm sure of that. So yes, it was a scary moment. I thought I would lose my family. I thought we would lose a lot of people. And people got hurt, but we are now on the other side and we are strong. We are without a tent, or we need to fix the tent. Things was broken, things was destroyed, the different places, but we survived and we are just ready to keep going. I want to encourage you all out there. This is a real life. We saw the power of God. Like the day before the tent went down, I had a moment. We had beautiful baptism. 30 people got baptized. You can see some pictures here. That was just before the tent went down, the day before. People got baptized in water. And one time I walked around and praying for people, and you can see here, and people got set free there. And I prayed for several people who received the Holy Spirit. Beautiful. The Holy Spirit came over them and they started to speak in tongues. The joy, look at the joy. Look at the excitement. And I had a moment. I was walking around there and I just loved it. I was like, God is here. The Holy Spirit is here. Like one by one got healed. Like it was so easy. One by one received the Holy Spirit. It was so easy. One by one got delivered. The Holy Spirit was there. It was so easy. People got baptized. We saw the power of God. And the day after, we got hit very, very hard. This is the life we are living. And I want to encourage you, live that life. Don't get discouraged. Get encouraged. Encourage. Keep going. Keep going, keep being bold. Maybe we will be slain. Maybe we will get an error on us. Maybe we will get hurt. Like Paul, he got stoned. Paul, he got hurt. It was a real life. It was a bloody life. He was in jail. He was in danger. He was hungry. He was thirsty. He was out there where it was not fun and it was not easy, like we are. But it's also out there you see the kingdom of God come. It's out there you are living. And I have one more testimony to add to my diary now. So I want to say to you, be encouraged, be bold, live this life out there. And don't listen to those people who said that, hey, if you experience opposition, when you experience things go against you, that you should just stay in bold and pray. No, no. God had promised us persecution. He had promised us hard times. He had promised us that things will go against us. Look at Paul's life. Look at Peter. Look at John. Look at James. Look at all the apostles who was in jail, who got whipped, who paid with their life. He have never promised us an easy life, but he have promised us that he's with us. And this is what we see. It's not an easy life we are living. It's a hard life. We are crying. We go through things, but it's a real life. And we see God's hand in it. We see how the Holy Spirit is leading. So I want to say to you, thank you for your prayers. Thank you for your support. This was a big attack. We went down with the tent. We got hurt. And it would take some time to just come up again. But we are going to come up again. We are going to rise again. We are going to fix the tent or get another tent. And we are going to hit the road again. And we are going to see the power of God like never before. Why? Because it's the enemy who tried to stop us. Why? Because we have something great waiting for us. Come and join us. Come and join us when we are out there. God bless you all. And sorry if it's a long video. I just want to share my heart in it. Because there's so many people sitting at behind the computer and, hey, just do this and just do this and just do this. But I want to say out there, not behind the computer, but out there is a real life. Out there is not just like this. It's not just like praying every time it works like that. It's not just like staying up, everything works like that. No, out there is real. It's bloody, it's hard, you are crying, you suffer, you go through things, and you sometimes want to give up and you want to run away. Why? Because it's not easy. But out there is real. Out there is beautiful. Out there is powerful at the same time. Out there we see the kingdom of God come at the same time. And this is what we are testifying. So now on the other side of all of this chaos, we are thankful for God. To God what he's doing. We are thankful and we are encouraged and our faith has been built up even more. Why? Because yes, we went down, but we saw God's hand in it. And God was there in the midst of it. And we all survived. God bless you and thank you for your prayers and see you out there. Bye bye.